Hello, student, and welcome. I want to take you through some terminologies that are used in the study of chemistry. We are going to start with the form one. And maybe before you proceed, you're asking yourself, why should we be familiar with the terminologies that we use in chemistry? What you'll realize is that chemistry is taught in English, but it has its language. It has some terminologies that are not necessarily the English, you know, the ordinary English, you know. So with the form one, you should be familiar with the following. Remember, I'm just highlighting some, not all of them. Like the term chemistry. And chemistry is a branch of science that deals with the study of composition, structure, properties and chemical changes that matter undergoes. Another term is drug. A drug is a natural or artificial substance that alters the normal functioning of the body when taken, or rather when used. Drug abuse is the use of a drug for a wrong purpose, and it includes the overdose and underdose of medicine. Then the term medicine. Medicines are drugs that can be used to cure, to prevent diseases, or relieve pain. Prescriptions. Prescriptions are written instructions by a qualified medical practitioner on how a certain drug or medicine should be used. A dose. A dose is the specific amount of medicine a patient should take for a given period of time. Matter, anything that exists and has mass and volume. Rather, it has mass and occupies space. Atom, the smallest particle of an element that can take part in a chemical reaction. Element, a pure substance which cannot be split into any other simpler substances. Compound, a pure substance that is made up of two or more elements that are chemically combined. A molecule. A molecule is a neutral and independent particle of an element or a compound. A mixture. A mixture is a substance that is made up of two or more substances that are physically combined. A school laboratory. This is a special room in a school where science subjects are taught, experiments are performed, and even chemicals are kept. A flame. A flame is a mass of burning gases. Remember, those are terminologies you will encounter in the topic Introduction to Chemistry. Form 1. Then the second topic in Form 1, simple classification of substances, you'll encounter terms like sublimation. Sublimation is a direct change of physical state from a solid to gas without passing through the liquid state. A solution. A solution is a homogeneous mixture of a solvent and a solute, or even for the miscible liquids. A saturated solution. This is a solution that contains the maximum amount of solute it can accommodate at a given temperature. Crystallization, the formation of solid particles from a saturated solution, oftenly when cooled. Water of crystallization, these are specific number of molecules are contained in a crystal, or rather they are trapped within the crystalline structure. Fractional distillation. This is a method of separating miscible liquids with a close but different boiling points. Chromatography. Chromatography is a method of separating substances with a different solubility, density, and adsorbent ability. We can say it's a method of separating colored substances, but it's not a must for the substances to be colored. Kinetic theory of matter. This theory states that Matter is made up of tiny particles that are in continuous random motion. Chemical symbol. These are letters. These are special letters representing chemical elements. Chemical equations. These are statements representing a chemical change. We go to the third topic, acid bases and indicators. The term acid. An acid is a substance that will dissociate or ionize in water to form hydrogen ions as the only positively charged ions. Otherwise, you can say it's a substance with a sour taste. A base. This is a substance that will ionize in water to produce hydroxyl ions. We can also say again it's a substance with a bitter taste. But the first definition, it's more conclusive. An alkali. An alkali is a water-soluble base. Otherwise, it's a substance that will dissolve in water to produce hydroxyl ions. An indicator. These are substances that will assume different colors while in acidic, basic, or neutral substances. They can be used to classify other substances as acid, base, or neutral. Universal indicator. This is a mixture of other several indicators which gives a range of colors in various substances. It can be used to test alkalinity or acidity of substances. A pH chart. This is a scale of numbers from 0 to 14, and again it is used to give the strength of bases or acids, that is testing the alkalinity or basicity of substances. A neutralization reaction. This is a reaction between an acid and a base to produce salt and water as the only products. The fourth topic, air and combustion. For instance, you need to know what is air. This is a natural mixture of gases. It occurs in nature. Then combustion. This is a reaction between a substance and oxygen with evolution of heat. Evolution of heat. Corrosion. Corrosion is the action of oxygen and moisture on a metal and other agents of nature, because it's not necessarily oxygen and moisture. Then rusting. Rusting is corrosion of iron, and it's the reaction of iron with oxygen in the presence of moisture. A catalyst. A catalyst is a substance that will alter the rate of a chemical reaction without being used or consumed. Oxidation. It's the addition of oxygen to a substance, the simplest definition. Otherwise, in advanced case, we define it as the loss of electrons from a chemical species. An oxidizing agent, therefore, is a substance that will add oxygen to another. All a chemical species which accepts electrons or receives electrons. Reduction, the removal of oxygen from a substance. That is, in advanced case, the gaining of electrons from a chemical species. Good. On a reducing agent, a substance that will remove oxygen from another. Otherwise, it is a species which will donate electrons. The last topic, water and hydrogen. Maybe one term we should know, it's the hydrocarbon. A hydrocarbon is a compound that is made up of hydrogen and carbon only. All others, the only elements. Good. That is maybe the end of Form 1. Next will be Form 2 concepts. Or rather, form 2 terminologies. Thank you so much.